Hey everybody, Clay Archer, CEO DPC Technology. Today we've got an awesome one. Today we're going to go over the new G6 line of cameras and we're going to cover the G6 Instant. The question I get all the time is whatever happened to the G5 Instant? The G4 Instant is a great little camera. It's a really popular camera. It's hard to find it in stock. And they never did a G5 version. And today they're introducing what I would call a massive upgrade in the G6 Instant. So for a quick unboxing, this is the same UniFi packaging we've come to know and love. So if you've seen the G4 Instant before, you'll be familiar with the mounting bracket. It's a very similar setup. Very easy to use. It comes with some different mounting plates and it stands on its own if you want to use it that way. There's a door with a safety latch on the bottom where the included USB-C cable goes. It is proprietary because it's on that angle, so don't lose your USB cable. It's hard to find one that won't line up and match there with that right angle. You'll also notice under the door there is a micro SD card slot. If you do want to do edge recording, that is available, meaning that if you lose connection to your NVR or your NVR goes offline, there will still be recording on the SD card in the camera. There's also a standard plug to plug the other end of the USB cable in. Acquisition is also similar to the G4 Instant. You can do it right on the app. I'll show you very quickly. It's super easy to acquire. One thing that I didn't record and I should have is that the Instants do audio prompting. So they'll let you know that they are on or that they are available to acquire. They actually say that over the speaker. And that's a really nice feature, you know, especially for somebody that hasn't done an acquisition before. It lets you know, hey, okay, it's online and ready to be acquired now. So you can go into the app and just go ahead and acquire it like normal. I acquired it through the app, super easy. Just click the button and it walks you through the acquisition and it did an update and it was super easy to acquire and get going. Really quickly, before I jump in the software and show you the difference between the G4 Instant and the G6 Instant, let's go over what makes this such a big generational jump. First of all, we're going from the 2K sensor to the 1/1/8 inch 8 megapixel sensor. You know, that's gonna give you that crispy 4K resolution and give you better low light performance. This camera visually is a much more impressive camera and it's putting it kind of on par with the other 4K cameras at this price point, which is impressive. It also gives you the advanced AI features like facial and license plate recognition, which also is awesome, especially at this price level. I don't have an AI key at home, but it's also gonna give you all these edge AI workflows that you get with the higher end cameras. I think the real headline here is that we're getting this high end, really nice sensor. We're getting all the AI features. We're getting them in this tiny little package and we're getting them for $179. Really is pretty amazing what they've packed into this little device. One other physical characteristic I do want to mention about this is that it is about a half an inch deeper than the previous G4 Instant. So from head on, it looks about the same, but if the inside profile, it's about a half an inch deeper. So with the specs out of the way, let's jump into the software and let's see what we're talking about here. All right, so you can see here, I've got the G5 Flex, the G4 Instant, and the G6 Instant, and they're at my house. And very quickly, the G4 Instant versus the G6 Instant. What I can see just very quickly is just the vividness. So like if you look over here in this piece of art over here in the corner, how nicely defined everything is. Or over here, hey, there's Mr. Sketch over there. But look at the grains of wood in the coffee table there. If I go over to the G4 Instant, I just don't get that same sharpness over there in the artwork. I don't get the same sharpness in the grains of wood there. You know, this is a good image, but the clarity and crispness of this image are just not quite on the same level as you can see this image is. And I don't know how well that's going to come over on YouTube, but just this, you know, you see the Zevia here and, you know, I can read 12 cans there, zero sugar, da 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 da. And if I go over in this one on the G4 Instant, I just can't read any of that there. And so how much is that going to really matter to you? I don't, you know, if you're just looking for a good image of the room, this G4 Instant does a really nice job. But if you are trying to really look at facial recognition and license plates and, you know, that kind of detail, you know, this Kroger bag here, while there's a little bit of fringing on that stuff, I can start to make stuff out. Whereas on this one, you know, you just really can't. And so, you know, that's gonna make a difference for those AI features. This is gonna make some difference, qualitative differences in that kind of imaging. So if I go to the timeline here too, I'm gonna go back quite a bit here in the timeline. Not a ton going on at night here, but how well that is doing at night. And then if I go from the G5 Instant over to the G4 Instant at the same time frame. Now this too is a good image here. It's not a horrible image, but you can just see the low light performance of the G6 Instance. It's just got same again, just there's just more detail. It's just doing better. You can actually see, look at the sunrise happening here in the distance. If I go in the G4 Instance, I can make it out, but I just can't make it out at that level that I can on the G6 Instant. You know, there's just really detail in that sky. If I go in there and I zoom in over on the sky, I can see a lot more on that sky than I can on this guy. How much is that really gonna make a difference for you? I'm not sure, but you know, for somebody that really is wanting the detail and the data there, that may be a real thing. So I'm gonna go back here. So here is last Friday. Actually, I put it out on the balcony last Friday just to see what it would do out in the wild of the outdoors. And it was really impressive out there. You can see it's resolving the sky and everything just beautifully. And it was detecting vehicles. So you can see if somebody went by on the beach, there's the lifeguard patrol, it would catch them and it would grab them going by. I am actually remote now at my office and not at my house, but it's really actually very cool. When I scrub the timeline and I'm there at my house, it's like a time lapse of the day, which is really pretty cool looking. It's not doing that here as I'm streaming from my house to my office, and it doesn't give me that scroll that way. But anyways, did very, very well out on the balcony. Also on the balcony, if you unmute the sound, it does a really nice job of catching the surf. So for me, this is kind of the perfect use case because I do have power out on the balcony, but I don't have Cat 6 cable run out to the balcony. So if I wanted to put a little camera out there, the Pelican go by, I could, and I can just set it up with wireless. So that's pretty awesome. I have a feeling a lot of people will do this. Like they want something in the garage, they want something in an outhouse or whatever. They've got Wi-Fi out there. Now you're able to put an 8-megapixel 4K camera out there that's doing facial recognition, that can do license plate recognition and have that low light capability. It really is pretty impressive. So let's bring that around full circle and land this plane. So who do I think this is for? First of all, for me here in my house with the G4 Instant, I probably will not be upgrading it to the G6 Instant. So for me in my house, I really just wanna see, A, is somebody home? You know, how's Sketch doing? That kind of stuff. And I don't need these higher end capabilities or the higher resolution. So for me, I'm going to put this at the front desk at my office where I can take advantage of the facial recognition. I do want the higher resolution. And I think that it's worth the difference there. All right, so let's talk about the 800-pound gorilla in the room, the fact that the G4 Instant was $99 and this one is $179. Obviously, that's a big jump, but I think that's kind of the wrong way to look at this. I think you come at it from the other direction, that traditionally to get an 8-megapixel camera, 4K resolution, with AI from UniFi, it's been close to $400. And now not only are we getting it at a lower price, but we're getting it in a super small and super flexible form factor. If you look at it that way, the $179 price tag is a super huge value. So for me, I think this G6 family represents a generational jump and an extreme value. And ultimately, I think what the consumer is looking for is the super high quality sensor. AI features in this form factor is really just an added bonus. And the price I think is fair for it. A lot of people similar to me that are using this camera are probably using it in these home situations where maybe you have a UDR7 or a smaller device that doesn't have capacity to have a bunch of high-end cameras. Ubiquiti addressed that in the press release saying if needed, users can reduce the recording resolution to 2K or even HD to increase the number of cameras on the console while still taking advantage of the improved image quality, low light performance from the larger sensor, and AI functionality. They also added that there will be no benefit on this one to adding an AI port. There's no need for that. It's got all the AI built into it. And their comment on the pricing increase in the press release was as follows. Previously, Instant cameras were budget introduction to UniFi options. Now we're offering 4K resolution with the 1 1/8-inch sensor, advanced AI detections on par with other G6 cameras, with no sacrifices to image quality. So basically they're saying the same thing. It's a little less expensive than the other G6 cameras with similar image quality. And that has been the same in my testing. So I'd be interested to see what everybody else thinks about this camera. I'm very excited about this camera. I'm not gonna leave it at my house. I'm actually gonna stay with the G4 Instant. I'm gonna bring it to the office, put it at the front desk. And I'm super interested to see how this compares against all the other cameras when I do my 2025 all cameras compare review, which is coming up soon. So I'd love to hear your comments down below. As always, I read all the comments and reply to all of them. Also, if you like this video, please give it a like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next video.